tried. I tried so very hard to empathize with all of your weaknesses. I implored every single one of you to just say no. And all my empathy got was for you to love Jeff Hardy that much more than you already did. But this will not deter me. I will stay the course. I still believe in teaching you people the difference between right and wrong. Oh, obviously it's going to be challenging listening to you people, and by the looks of some of you, it's going to be a big challenge. But just like any other challenge that's come down the pipe in my lifetime, I'm going to meet that challenge head on, like a man, just like I did last week. Let's take a look.
Jeff has said many times in the past he likes to live in the moment, and I just want Jeff to know that he should enjoy this moment because it's not going to last very long.
You know, Jeff, honestly, the last few weeks...
Oh, come on! What a cheap shot! See if Hulk Hogan and Jeff Hardy! See if Hulk is trying to physically destroy Jeff Hardy! Hardy is helpless!
I want everybody all over the world to tune into SmackDown next week, because that's when I'm going to take my World Heavyweight title back. See, now I know why you people love Jeff Hardy so much. It's because you are all just like him. And in turn, Jeff Hardy is just like all of you. The reality is, none of you have the strength to be straight edge. You gravitate towards Jeff because it's the easy way out. It's easier to be weak like Jeff, because you sure can't be strong like me. And you can boo all you want. I know why you boo. You know why you boo. It's because I tell the truth. And the truth sometimes hurts, doesn't it? For instance, what does it say on your prescription bottle of pills? Take one every 4 hours. Well, don't tell me that you people don't gobble 4, 6, 8 at a time like they were Pez. That is drug abuse. I don't do that. I also don't smoke. And those who do are stupid. You gotta be stupid to not listen to the Surgeon General, especially when he prints the warning label on the package of smokes. You gotta be a fool. Now we can talk about those funny cigarettes. And you obviously know what I'm talking about because you cheer, and that's utterly sad. That's pathetic. I can't even wrap my head around you people cheering. Because when you smoke those funny cigarettes, not only is that hazardous to your health, it's also illegal. So those who have taken a puff, not only are you poisoning yourself, you're also breaking the law. So the vast majority of everybody here in this arena is a criminal. I am not a criminal. I never have been, and I never will be. Now let's talk about alcohol. I've saved the best poison for last, you see, because this is a gateway drug. Don't tell me not a single one of you in here has ever said, I'm going to go out for one drink, and one leads to two, and two drink leads to three, and then it's a double of this and a shot of that, and then your head winds up in the toilet night in and night out. Congratulations. That is alcoholism. And in my book, if you even take one drink, you're an alcoholic. So I understand why you people love Jeff Hardy so much. I understand why Jeff loves you. It's because you're all weak. But whether you like it or not, whether you know it or not, you deserve better. This entire world deserves better. What you need is a leader. You need a strong leader who's going to stand up in the face of adversity and just say no. You need a strong leader that's going to carry the banner of the World Heavyweight Championship with honor, with pride, respect, dignity, integrity, and class. What you people need is a straight-edged World Heavyweight Champion. You need CM Punk.